Well, you know, the downward is heavenward thing, I thought it was just a nice phrase because it's kind of like...
It is a great phrase.
Because just that things can go bad in your life and you can just feel like you're going just lower and lower and lower and lower, but at some point you just got to say, well, this is where I am, you know.
One of the most intriguing elements about this whole thing that I read is that you retain, this is the record company,
on
their hands and knees. Hands and knees.
Why are you down there, by the way?
This is the A&R man. Mr. A&R man there allowed you to retain your vinyl rights.
He's a hell of a guy, isn't he?
Why was that important for you guys as a band? First of all, to want to have vinyl, and then the fact that they obviously didn't want it, and you guys did.
Vinyl's beautiful. I mean, it's more than anything, it's a great memento of what you've done. You know, it's this huge slab of wax, and it sounds nice, and it looks nice. It's just kind of a nice trophy of what you've worked hard for.
We're going to Parasol Mail Order. That is it's also a distributor. It's also a record label, and it's home of Mud Records also. And
these guys distribute your vinyl?
These guys do our vinyl, and they also distribute our reissues for Electro 2000 and whatever else we'll think to give them. She's not at work, she's not at school, she's not in bed. I think I finally broke her. I bring home everything I want, nothing that she needs. There's a store in here too, but a lot of people don't really just like come and shop, but they do most of business mail order. Hi.
Here's all your LPs.
Oh, all right.
Oh, how look at this. Look at
the vinyl. If you want to carve open a bunch of them.
Looks like they're selling pretty good.
Nice. It used to be this high.
All right, we've sold this many then.
So here are all of our Martians go home.
Martians go home.
And the stack used to come out to here and be taller, so.
Oh, yeah. Well,
so
that's good.
They're doing a great job. There they are.
So the advantage here from a financial point of view, too, is that your royalty rate being your own record company is that...
It's about a three orders of magnitude better than what those other guys are giving us. So.
Yeah, sure.
No, it's good, though.
He's not making 6 cents on each one of these babies.
You know, we take them on the road and we sell them, and I don't have to, like, if I want to take CDs, I mean, we own these, so I can just come over and grab a box and, you know,
there's no
sell them.
Channels.
And we can, that way we can sell them cheap to kids and stuff. So it's pretty, it's great for everyone. It's really nice.
The lyrics aren't on here, but the one thing that sort of came out was whoever's writing these lyrics, is that you? Do you have a background in mathematics?
I don't, but I'm really into it right now. In fact, I'm terrible. I just about flunked out of college when I was forced to take math classes because it didn't really interest me at the time. And I've kind of come around and I'm really into, I'm trying to teach myself math right now and I'm trying to teach myself quantum physics. This is just something that really I've enjoyed reading about for the last couple of years, so I kind of happens to be one of many things I'm kind of thinking about right now, and it just kind of leaks in. And I've been reading a lot of stuff about how like quantum mechanics is kind of changing the way that people look at the universe, and is almost like bordering on scientific proof that we really all are part of one thing, you know. And I think it's a really exciting idea, and so it kind of to me it. Kind of leaks over into relationships and just relations of humans and between each other and where we're at in the grander scheme of things too. Locust skins from the locust trees, hang on to their faces, she screams to me, clearly in this afternoon, clearly we will have to turn and come home soon. The band kind of likes to shoulder as many of the responsibilities as we can within reason of our touring and everything too, you know. And I think some people get in a trap where they're just like, don't know where their next show is, they don't know what time they need to wake up in the morning, they don't know how to string their own guitar anymore or anything, and
it's easy to hurt yourself like that.
Yeah,
you get too lazy and you just end up playing bad because of it, because you've given up all of your responsibilities and, you know, you turn into a slug or something.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, I don't know.
It's easy to get spoiled.
Yeah. You know? We have a road crew, but we're there, you know, we carry gear with them and we, you know, I'm actually, tonight is going to be the first time that someone strung a guitar for me. We have a guitar tech.
That feels really weird.
It's kind of scary.
It's really scary.
Yeah, he's going to like put strings on the guitar. Hope he puts them on in the right order. So, we'll see.